The graduation and commencement ceremonies are officially open. You may be seated. My name is Robin Kimbrough Hayes, and I have the awesome privilege of serving as the chaplain and special advisor to the President of United Methodist Affairs here at McGarry Medical College. Let us pray. Oh God, this is the day that you have made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. We are so thankful for this day, a day when we celebrate that you indeed can do the seemingly impossible. A day that we celebrate the truth that hard work and perseverance pay off. And according to the psalmist and these graduates here today, weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. In spite of challenges, loss, grief, setbacks, setups, and sleepless nights, you brought them to this point to realize a dream to bring healing, knowledge, and compassion to the world. Then, oh God, we need it now more than ever. We are grateful for your favor on the Harry Medical College to be used as a vessel for this divine calling. You work with professors, administration, those who serve our coffee and breakfast, and kept the hallways clean, and parents, spouses, children, family, and friends who supported them, wiped away their tears, and inspired them not to give up. Oh God, you are an awesome God. Now work with these graduates. Use them to be a source of your amazing grace, love, and more compassion. Use them to bring healing to the world and into the cries of justice. Let their worship be an expression of service to all. And may it give praise to you wherever they go. It is in your name we do pray. And all of God's people say it. Amen.
Morning. We have the Board of Trustees, Deans, the Schools of Medicine, the School, the Registered Research, Company and Staff. We want to welcome you, our graduates, 146 ceremony and 30 degrees. We want to offer a special welcome to Dr. Vasa Sakai, who is our Board of Trustees. We look to Dr. Adams and look at Megan and Fred. For you, 2021 graduates, we recognize your perseverance, self-discipline, and continue to support the last one in the field. Especially in this extraordinary year of upheaval and disruption of the COVID-19 pandemic. Even though the world is new, the place we live is considering and preparing the producer on understanding the importance of that struggle to the achievement of this milestone. With that, I'd like to introduce Dr. Les Adams to share the story with us from the Harry Medical College.
Thank you very much, Dr. Wilbur. Good morning! Well, I'm so glad to be here, but not nearly as glad as you. Mr. President, graduates, faculty, ladies and gentlemen. Let me go off script just a moment. You know, it's at times like these when we have to pause. What I call a sense of hope. Time when we look back over our journey, when we savor this moment. But perhaps more importantly, it's a time when we contemplate with typical anticipation what the future holds. And so as you do that on this morning, I ask that you never, ever forget your journey. There are ancestors, just parents and grandparents, and those even before them who prayed took just a little time to pray for you. And I, like you, am so glad they did. So glad they did. So glad they prayed. Because it was May 28th of 1978 at 5:30 in the afternoon when I sat where you sat. Here in this afternoon, like you, waiting for my turn to cross the stage and put it and to receive my diploma. I was part of the 103rd commencement ceremony here in Harrah, and it was Sunday. Dr. Lloyd E. building behind you, in front of me, his name was Don. He was our college president, and I was filled with excitement, joy, anticipation. But I imagine many of you are today. In many respects, it was a time of looking back at all I had experienced, the mentors I had known, the colleagues I had studied with, and the valuable relationships that I developed, many of which still remain today. It's a time for looking ahead, my residency, the practice that I hope to have and eventually achieve, and all the promises that have come from life as a physician, and all that I would owe to my experience as a Maharaj. That was one of the most special days of my life. And I would reflect upon it through years and years to come. And now it's your turn. Yes, it's your turn because you've come through my house at a time of our president. This past year has been one challenge worldwide, but you have seen it from the unique perspective of being a student of the health sciences. Whatever you're training over these past 3 years, this last year will affect the way you practice your disciplines and the way that you see issues in health equity and, let me emphasize, health inequity and in public health for the rest of your career. You were in the right place at the right time. The Proverbs reminds us, the mind of a man plans his way, but the Lord directs his steps. Your steps were ordered to walk through this campus at this extraordinary time, just like they were ordered to walk across this stage this morning. Therefore, as chair of the Board of Trustees of Maharaj Medical College, I offer you congratulations, not only from me, not only from the Board of Trustees, but from generations of ancestors who came before us, and from the generations of folk just like you and me to come. We offer you encouragement, power, strength, and faith upon as you continue your journey. Congratulations.
The hood is a special part of the academic realm.
that imitates your scholarly and professional achievements. The hood itself symbolizes the academic degree beyond the bachelor's degree. For the class of 2021, as you approach the stage to be hooded and to receive your diploma, many thoughts may cross your mind. The long hours of study, the projects, test taken, and the personal sacrifices that you, your family, and others have made for you. You have earned the right and privilege for the degrees that you are receiving today, and they will serve you well into the future. Congratulations. Good morning, Mr. Chair, Board of Trustees, Mr. President, and faculty. The School of Graduate Studies and Research is honored to hood and to recommend and confirm the degrees for the Doctor of Philosophy in Biomedical Sciences, the Master of Science in Public Health, and the Master of Health Sciences degrees. These candidates have made significant contributions to science and the public health policy are outstanding. And then